So, hello again, everyone. We're continuing to develop our social network in Go, and we shall continue to write the functional test for our protocol, and hopefully, we will start to do something about the protocol implementation and to improve it somehow to make it easier to extend. Okay, so what we left off. We wrote a test that registers a new user here, logs in, gets the session ID, and connects to our web socket. And then starts some Go routines and sends the first request to get messages and gets the response and checks that everything is okay. So what should we do then? So obviously, we need to improve some of this code at first. So, excuse me. So first, we need to do something like this. We extract this piece of code to another function. It would be like setup and get connection. And it would receive the address, and it would return the result of websocket.conf. So it would be something like this. The result of .conf is the connection, and the connection and an error if it is present. So doing something like this, WebSockets con and error. We need this slip 1 second to make our application listen the address, and we can make it probably less. It should be set up in config, but actually, for this test, I think 100 milliseconds is more than enough. And here we get this connection. Let's try again. Let's build it and okay, so we have first error. Yeah, okay. A lot of if error is not nil checks, but we need them because otherwise nothing will work properly, even in this test case. Okay, next we need to start this Go routine, and obviously we don't need to make it in line, and we could start it in a separate function as well. It would be something like response reader thread, and it receives the connection, and list of channels. So head in line users list, head user connected, our chain bool, and response channel is this type. It's no longer anonymous. And when it ends, then we obviously have finished processing, because yeah, there's nothing left to do. Okay, so response reader thread, and we don't even just return. We shouldn't just return. We should do something like this. So it's not required to write a return in this case, of course, because it exits here. So so we will do this, head user connected. Yeah, the order of arguments is important. So head user, head online list, and response channel. Okay. Yeah, I say okay a lot, but what can you do? Next thing that we need to improve here is the way that we send requests. Of course, we shouldn't do something like we shouldn't write something like this by hand, and it should be a function as well. So I would call method or something like this. So first would be message type, sequence ID. I'm not sure whether or not we need it, but it should be auto incremented, so probably should be something like this. Sequence ID would be star int, and also the request itself would be just empty interface. And in response, it would receive a response. It should supply the pointer to empty interface, but it's empty interface as well, so it would be this interesting construct. So it is where response will be written, and error will be returned if there are some there is something to return. And we would also need a response channel. Yeah, you don't need okay, so we will just return the empty interface, and no. So we'll see how it would be better to write it. But anyway, we need a response channel here. The same one. It could be a global variable, but I'm not sure that it's a good thing to do in this test case. So our code will then become something like this, where we, oh yeah, of course, we need a connection as well. So it would be arguments with connection first. It would be something like this. And then it would get sequence ID pointer. I don't like to supply pointers, to be honest, so it would be just sequence ID, and we will return a new value of sequence ID instead. So it will be current sequence ID, and we will return new one. It will be request and response. We can avoid writing the type if it is the same. So our call method will be suited only for the test, nothing else. So first we need to write the request. It would be something like this. So we could even do fprintf if we want. So it would be the request sequence ID, then line, new line, then the message, and new line, and that's it. So it would be then message sequence ID and the request JSON Marshall request. Of course it could be error as well. So we need to check for it and return error in this case. We shouldn't have any problems marshalling this value, but still it needs to be done. Then we say that we allocate the reply here, and it would be response. Then data is already redefined. Do we have the same here? And if everything is okay, we we just supply the new sequence ID and that's all. So we know that we need to get reply get messages, and we also know the response message ID. As well, the response message name that we want. And as you can see, we have a lot of arguments here. So it would be better to do something like a method on some type instead of trying to get so many arguments. So that's what we will do. It would be type test connection, and it would have the WebSocket connection. It would have the response channel as well. And it would have obviously sequence ID. Yeah, and that's all the state that we want to have. So it will be then defined as something like this. No, the response message type and sequence ID we no longer return. We just return error. That's easier. It's not go test data. It's just p.c. We read the role response here, and in general we get much better code this way. So this is the state that is preserved between calls, and we only supply arguments that are really needed. So we'll allocate the state here. It would be something like, I don't know, P is good enough. We have just connection, and we have connection response channel. And sequence ID would be just 0. I guess it is what we need to. It's what we need to track ourselves. We don't need to do this, of course. So we replace the call to the direct write to connection to call method, pcall method, and message is request get messages. And response message type would be reply messages list. It must be reply messages list. That's what we expect. And of course, sequence ID would have to be casted to float 64, sadly. It's not the best way to do this, but that's what I do, at least until I figured out the better way to uncertainize the response. So our role response is serialized here. Okay. Yeah, I know that I say okay a lot, but what can you do? And here would be requests get messages then. And user 2, date end, and limit. And the only argument that we did supply was limit, so I'll just transfer it for now. And we should get something like this here. So I'm not sure, we don't need to write the pointer here, because we supply it when we pass the argument. Well, we shall see. We shall have to try. And if it was an error, then we'll return it. And we should check that we had user connected and such. Okay, let's see what it gives to us. Yeah, we got the same as before, and let's make sure that it really works by altering the expected reply And we could try to send wrong request as well and see what it gives to us. And instead of getting reply messages list, I expected reply messages list for our request. So expected reply messages list for request get messages 1, and it said that it is reply error. And invalid. It is an invalid request type. So it seems to work. Of course, we didn't get any. We didn't get any messages from a user. So. We're just testing the protocol itself, not that API to call get messages works. So the protocol seems to work, and we should add test for other requests as well. So we have request send message, for example. And we can register even more users. Do we need to get user ID for our user that was registered? And up until now, we still didn't get it. We just got the session ID, and we didn't get any session at all. So one solution to this would be to register a user with the static user ID, and always send a message to it and to this user, and make sure not make sure, and this way we would always we'll have a user with a lot of messages, and in this case it's not bad. We need to test for it, so we will try, and I will even stop the rebuilder probably. excuse me. No. No, I won't do this, but we can log in as some users. And we should actually see not online users in messages, but users that have something for us. If it makes sense. Okay, so we can still probably print the reply. To request get messages and send several more messages. So here is how we call new methods, and let's it would be reply one. It'd be reply one. We will test the Next request, send message. I'm not sure. We should get reply generic probably. Yeah, for this one. So request, send message. And we will send to our first user. And it should be Safari. Yes. And we expect to get reply generic. And here we request send message. User 2 and what to send. So it is user 2 1. And text would be hello from test. And we get another reply. And we couldn't print it as well. Apply to request and message. Would be reply one. And of course, we could go even further and probably move this code to another function. Maybe it's a good thing to do. So we shall say that it is test get messages and it needs just okay. So it's just P and P is the test connection instance. And it looks like this. So we test get messages here. Check for flags and then we test another method. It would be test send message. And we won't need to use reply one name here. That doesn't look very good. And so we return error as well. We don't exit the application when we're doing testing. I'm not sure that it is the best and the shortest way to write this test, but we'll see. So launch the application and we get the reply generic and we see that a message was successfully sent, and that means that if we saw this user, then we would probably see the message from him, but we can't do this because we don't see it in the list. And we probably should fix it. If we want to write a message to a user that is online, then we will have a button in users list. And in messages, we will only have the the dialogues that users have currently. And it will require for us to add a new request type probably as well. Chrome has message only to Firefox, to Safari, and Safari only has messages written to Chrome. And let's use a little bit of HTML. And we don't need the JavaScript inspection about unterminated statement, because I like to write without semicolons in JavaScript because it looks like Go and more and what is more important is that you must understand how semicolons work in JavaScript, because if you write something like this, like return one, then it is an unreachable code. The it will not return an object, it will return an undefined, because it actually reads as this, and this is what PHP Storm is telling us, that it's an unreachable statement. Okay, that's why I write without semicolons, so that you always understand how they work and not make these mistakes. What we need to do is to show messages that show messages only from users that we had some history, and I'm searching for a place where we draw these users. Setup messages pane would be probably the place to do this, and change location. I can't really find it, so I suppose that it is updated when we get when we get an event about new users, so it is done in redraw users. Yeah, we can see that it actually is true. That's when new user comes online, then this pane is redrawn as well. So if we log out as Firefox, for example, we should see that Firefox has lost connection, and then when Firefox connects back, then we see that it appears instantly. So if we close Firefox, then it will close connection, and so we'll see it go offline. But if we just log out, then it is not considered as closed connection, because probably Firefox still keeps connection to WebSocket. And we should probably force the logout when, and we should force a close of connection when you of WebSocket connection when user logs out. Otherwise, it still can do something using this connection. Okay. We need to remake this. We already have the code to draw the message users, but it doesn't do what we need. And we could probably set code style. For JavaScript, and it should be indented with 4 spaces. So I don't really get what it's trying to tell me. Okay, I'll deal with this later. So function. Redraw message users, and this function should be placed into messages.js, not here. And we need all users here. So we need to do something like this. But not all users should be here. It should be message users instead. Well, good, just users. And we accept the users list. And all users doesn't have all users that we have in the system. It has only online. Sorry, it only has online users. So we shouldn't use all users here. And we just print user info ID and name without any escaping. That's not good. And you shouldn't write such code in production. You should always escape values or use some frameworks to draw this. To make it still work, for now we just replace it with redraw message users with and all users, and it still works, but it doesn't have the check for if user ID equals our user ID, so we can see ourselves as well, but we shouldn't be able to write message to ourselves. Yeah, can log incoming message. That's interesting. Okay, we got one one message here. It's out, so we can actually see this. But we couldn't insert the second entry with user ID and user ID 2 being the same. I just deleted this entry, so we don't get these broken records. It's another bug that could be tested automatically, actually. Okay, we got redraw message users, and we need to move it to messages.js and activate it there. We need to do this when the location is changed to messages, and uh, when this messages pane is activated. And we don't get any event for that, but we can do it, we can improve it so that we get events in this case. So change location would be show current. And yeah, we can have loaders for messages. So messages would register loader, then messages would be load message users. Load message users would be doing another request. It would be request get messengers users, and it won't have any parameters other than limit probably. Because we need to show only the we need to show only the most recent ones, so that we don't draw too much, because user could have a lot of people that it talked to. And upon receiving a reply, we just redraw users, redraw message users with this reply. And on the go side, we need to add new request type, request. Could guest messages users and get and make a request type here, request structure. So this would have a limit that would be uint64. Request get messages users, and we need to add a handler for that, and we'll do a copy paste at the moment. So request get messages users be new request get messages users. Just decode it here. Can I decode request and then process request. Okay, so process get messages users. And we don't need this. But we can always pass it so that we don't need to have different arguments lists. So we called this process get messages users and we copied the previous function to get arguments, and of course it would be request get messages users. We don't need to parse anything here. We need to add a new prepare statement. And this needs to be redone as well, because you can't make all the prepare statements when you launch the application, because there could be a lot of them. A lot of query types that you need to execute, and not all of them are needed when you start the application. So get messages users statement. Get messages user statement would be select distinct select distinct user ID 2 from user social messages. So select distinct user ID 2 from social messages where user ID is our placeholder, and we have some limit, and order by timestamp descending. We don't have a good index for that, as far as I know. Or, no, actually we do. So this query should use an index. We could even check for that. Let's open the query, and where user ID 2 would be 1, limit 10, for example. Let's execute the query. It's not in select list, and so it's incompatible with distinct. Yes, it could be a problem that we can't do this. So we should do something like this instead. It would be maximum of TS, and then group by user ID 2 and it will be already sorted, but it is not specified in the standard, so we shouldn't rely on that. We order my by maximum timestamp descending, and make a limit. We even get the maximum timestamp here. If we do explain, then we get probably a full table scan. Yeah, it's not the best query. As you can see, it's using where, index, temporary, and file sort. But it is using index. We will maybe have to optimize this query later, because it will be a very popular one, because it is executed each time that you open the messages list. But for now we will just use this query. It's not used anywhere, but we will fix this soon enough. For user, we not only need to get its ID, we need to get its name as well. And we could use join, but yeah. We could use join here, but it will not scale. We'll have to make several queries if we had several MySQL servers. So in this case, it is a temporary solution until we get database sharded, and I hope we will in some time. So we do an inner join of these users table, and it would be user ID would be messages user ID 2, and we select the username. So it's not an easy query for MySQL, but what can you do? So it should be a proper query, except for that table name is different. And now we can see that query is considered correct. Okay, so we select user ID 2, username, and max timestamp. We can even get rid of this alias names, because we use column IDs. We don't use these names anywhere. So process get messages for users, and we don't need to execute the statement. We need to get rows for that, so query would look different and reply would look different as well. And you can see how many things we need to do to add a new request, and it could be simplified, of course, and we should do this in near future. So what we need to hear to write here would be something like this: get let's just use a statement, we query it, and we say that we supply limit, and not only limit, but user ID, of course. And query returns role sent error. So if we got an error, then we would need to do something about it. Yes, and we have helper methods for doing this. Could not get users list for messages. And reply won't be generic at all. We will have name and user ID and the result. So for rows next. I'm sorry. So for rows next, we would need to do a scan, and it returns an error. So we got user ID 2 and username, and the reply format that we're expecting is the same as for just users list. It would be ID and name. And reply would be reply get users list. So it would be just reply get messages users. We would have users and JS user list info. We use a separate type because we use uint 64 as user ID, and JavaScript only supports 32-bit integers, so we need to convert it to the JavaScript format. So we will scan user ID and username, which is string. And so I already forgot what we had. Okay, user ID and name. So user ID and name. And if we had an error in this case, then we should do the same thing. And always close the rows response. It frees the memory. So the response would be it won't be just success true. It would be not generic, but reply get messages users. And we say that users should be initialized. So we create a new element here. And we should have we need to have just JS user info, not user list info. We don't need to supply information about whether or not they're friends or something like that. We just need name and ID, and that's all. Yeah, so ID, user ID, and name. Oh, ID is not just user ID, of course. Should be converted to a string first. And name would be username. And we append it to apply users. And send this reply to tell user. And of course, in every reply, we should include base reply so that we have fields, sequence ID, and type. Of course. And as you can see, we don't have the cleanest code for that, and it's not the shortest one as well. And that is one of the restrictions of static typing, that you need to write more code generally, but you can find proper solutions to that by making a good type hierarchy, but sometimes you have to write this code. But in our case, we could greatly simplify it, and I hope we will do it sometime. Okay, we added a new request type. Probably doesn't compile. yeah, build failed. and says that we can't use pointer instead of struct itself, and it they're right. We can't. We don't need the intermediate intermediate variable as well. And user ID is used twice, so we need to find a new name. It would be just ID, probably, then. So let's see. Let's run a test then. It couldn't prepare because it doesn't know the max timestamp column, and yes, I got rid of that. We must restore it. Yeah, okay, it compiles now and even runs. So Chrome is not online. Oh yeah, now it is. But it couldn't perform the request for messages for some reason. Couldn't get users list because it expected three arguments in scan, not two. We don't really need to select this timestamp, but perhaps we have no other choice. It would be string, probably. It's undefined, undefined, undefined. So it obviously read something. Let's see what it was. Not messages, but events is what we need, and it replied with messages users. No, it replied the generic response, and of course it's not generic. We expect it to be apply messages. Oh, apply get messages users. We should define this constant as well, so that we get static typing. And we probably could use this variable as well. So why would do we get undefined then? Because it is not how it is not the correct format. And the correct format would be reply.users. And now it works. So Chrome only has messages written to Safari. Firefox has not written to anyone. And here we have a message. Here we have messages for some test user. And these links do not work. Some reason they don't work, even though we should have specified everything. So let's see. Events get request get messages users. And so we receive an empty list. Why is that? Get messages to user 2 from user 1, and we don't get anything. Let's see, we have user ID D1 and user ID 2 equals 2, and so we have all types of messages, so it should return something, but it does not for some reason. Oh, it's because it is wrong user ID. It should be user ID 2. Not just user ID. So I didn't change it. I format the user ID, not the ID of a friend here. Now it should work. Yes, it works. So now we show messages with users that we have written to. And Chrome still doesn't see it, but at least we did something. And we'll need to have an interface in this users list to write a message or to have so we'll need to merge the online list and messages list, for example, to be able to write to someone. But for now we can see how it works. We send a message and we now get three users. And if we write from Chrome, and refresh the page, then Chrome gets first, as you can see. We didn't wait for a reply to send a message for some reason. Okay, so we have a new interface element, interface feature, and new request type. But for some reason we couldn't, we didn't get a proper response. And I forgot to check for errors here. Maybe we'll see something. Invalid response, expected reply generic, and instead we got event new message. Oh yeah, that's true. We got events about new messages when we send it, so that's a very good point. If we got and event new message. Then we could check that we could check that message of user from. We could even do this check right here. So if value user from, it would be float 64 as well, probably. If it is not equal to 1, then we should log it. I'm sorry. We should log that we got something strange. Improper event. New message. Expected user from to be equal to 1. And we should set flag about head new message. We could give some shorter names. And we could have shorter names here as well. So it would be head new message. It would be online, it would be connected, and this would be new message. It's much shorter, and we don't really lose any information here. And we check for another flag that we really did have a new message. But it should happen at the end of execution after some timeout, after short timeout. And we, of course, we panicked. No one expected something else. And it is string because we return user IDs as strings for JavaScript. And we got something strange because I suppose that event new message case doesn't work then, because I don't understand. We shouldn't send this to the response channel because it's not the default case. So let's print all we see then. and we should log the send requests as well. Oh, that's not as easy as I thought. Okay, so log printf data. At least. Not really data, but request, but data would be string then. Got user ID 2. We will print type as well. Type of request. Be request get messages, and we got response. Excuse me. So we got response. So we sent request get messages, and we got response event online users list. They're connected, and when we send message, we got a reply. Generic. Then we got a reply of type. Got a reply of type event new message. And for some reason it's received a different response. So we will also log here. That's got event new message. So we did get event new message, and so we don't get any errors here. I don't really understand it, because why would we get this? So test send message would receive proper reply. So it wrote the request there, and received on response channel. For some reason, the response the event response was written there. Don't really understand this. Should probably declare value here so that it's not reused. Let's try this. And again. And again. So probably the problem was that we reused the value to tell us not nil. Okay, let's remove this debug information, although we could do something like debug print that won't be seen in the normal test, but if we need it, we could use this. So yes, you shouldn't reuse the same value when you are doing decode to a map. That's pretty obvious, of course, but excuse me, it's worth mentioning. We should have sent a lot of messages by now, and it's hello from test. And if we write something to Safari, then we should see Chrome come first here. But all these test users, all these test users would be polluting our messages users list, and we should add some interface to be able to write to people that we want and to close open chats with people that we don't want. But we will not do this now, probably. Okay, this was probably the end of this episode. We didn't do too much, but we tested that we send a message and that we get a successful reply. We can see these messages in our interface, and we check that we receive a notification about a new message that was received, and it was received from user one, but it is an outgoing type of message. So that's why we receive it, so that we can show it in our interface. So I think that's it's all time that we have today, and thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.